Today, we're talking about how to safely use Windows 7 now and in the future. No operating system is perfect. Even with Windows 11, there's always the possibility of a security or data breach. Our goal here with Windows 7 is to minimize the risk and mitigate potential damage. To get started, we need to talk about Windows updates. We only want to use updates that were officially released by Microsoft. While unofficial service packs sound great, there is a risk that they may contain malicious code, intentionally included or not. The safest approach is to only use updates officially released by Microsoft. For a clean install of Windows 7, install the prerequisite patches to repair the Windows Update feature, then fully update the system. This process can take a few hours to complete. After the initial round of updates has been installed, check for updates again, and install any additional updates that are found. Repeat the process until no more updates are found. Next, we need antivirus software. The safest approach to using an antiquated operating system is running antivirus software, so we will be using Avast. I get this comment or something similar at every mention of antivirus software, that you don't need antivirus software. If you use common sense, just don't click on anything suspicious, don't pirate software, don't click on ads, etc. There is a school of thought that antivirus software isn't needed. If you are sensible and careful enough about what you do online, only visiting legitimate websites, using official software stores, and policing the links you click on with a degree of scrutiny, you probably won't encounter any malware or viruses. As our goal is to use Windows 7 in the safest way possible, we want to use antivirus software. Then we need a web browser. Bottom line, don't use Internet Explorer. The latest version of Internet Explorer available for Windows 7 is version 11, which has not been updated in many years. There are a number of other browsers that work better than Internet Explorer and put the system at far less risk. Possibly the best option is UR browser. However, it's not the only viable alternative to Internet Explorer. Support for Internet Explorer 11 ended on June 15th, 2022. This means that any new vulnerabilities identified for the browser have not been patched, and never will be, at Microsoft. To maintain security, we need to replace Internet Explorer. While we are on the subject of web browsers, it is important to review the browser settings, as the default configuration is likely not the most secure. Keep your browser updated. Browsers do not automatically update like some software does. For most browsers, you can check for and apply updates in the About section. Check your browser settings. In whatever browser you choose, there are settings for privacy and security. We want to look through these settings and adjust them to be more cautious and restrictive. Let's start with Edge and highlight a few points of interest, starting with the Strict setting for tracking prevention. The tracking prevention feature in Microsoft Edge protects users from online tracking by restricting the ability of trackers to access browser-based storage as well as the network. Websites use trackers to collect info about your browsing. Some trackers collect and send your info to sites you haven't visited. The Strict setting blocks a majority of trackers for all sites. Next, we want to toggle on Send Do Not Track Requests and toggle off Allow Sites to Check if You Have Payment Methods Saved. Under Use Secure DNS to specify how to look up the network address for websites, select Choose a Service Provider. and pick a security-focused DNS provider like Cloudflare, or enter your own preferred provider. From here, we want to toggle on Enhance Your Security on the Web and set it to Strict. Now let's take a look at the settings for Google Chrome. Under Privacy and Security, click on Security. Under Safe Browsing, select Enhanced Protection. Then scroll down to the Advanced section. Toggle on Always Used Secured Connection and Use Secured DNS. Pick Custom and select a security-focused DNS provider like Cloudflare, or enter your own preferred provider. Then we want to switch to Cookies and Other Site Data and toggle on Send a Do Not Track request with your browsing traffic. Moving on to Firefox. In the Settings menu, click on Privacy and Security. Under Enhanced Tracking Protection, select Strict. Under Send Websites a Do Not Track signal that you don't want to be tracked, select Always. Now to switch to the General tab, scroll to the very bottom. Under Network Settings, click on the Settings button. Scroll to the bottom of the next window and mark Enable DNS over HTTPS. Pick a security-focused DNS provider like Cloudflare, or enter your own preferred provider. Next, we need to talk about ads, more specifically, blocking them. Edge has many options available for ad blockers. For demonstration, we can use Adblock Plus. You may notice after adding the extension that websites don't have as many ads on them, but that's just on the surface. Adblock Plus has some additional settings that are worth taking a look through. Under the General tab, mark Block Additional Tracking, Block Push Notifications, and Block Social Media Icon Tracking. Then scroll down to the Acceptable Ads section. This is personal preference. Showing acceptable ads allows ads to play on YouTube, so your favorite creators can make a few extra dollars when you watch their videos. Now to switch to the Advanced tab. In the Filter Lists section, you can add additional lists. There are some great filter lists available from adblockplus.org, like anti-circumvention, malware protection, notification blocking, and more. In the same vein as ad blocking and security, there is a tool called Spybot Search and Destroy. This has a feature named Browser Immunization. The process has a cool progress bar and really feels like something happened that makes you a little safer online. What it does is add entries to the Windows hosts file, which effectively blocks communication to those domains. You can manually add entries to the hosts file as well. Browsers have a tendency to ask if you would like to save usernames and passwords when you sign into a website. The built-in password managers are lacking in a number of ways, but the idea is an excellent one. There are third-party tools like KeePass that can manage your passwords. It even has a feature that can generate new passwords for you at various strengths and lengths. Nobody likes to key in passwords, and the average user has over 100 passwords in use. Using a password manager is a must if you want to stay safe online. Use two-factor authentication. For any service that offers it, turn on two-factor authentication. Yes, it is an additional step when you sign in, but it's well worth the inconvenience, especially if you still use Windows 7. That extra step can be the difference between safe and sorry. I would be remiss if I didn't mention virtual private networks. I'm sure you've seen many and various sponsored ads for VPNs, like this one.
Browsing the internet can be risky business, so why don't you protect yourself and browse anonymously with a hidden IP?
The bottom line is that it would be safer to use a VPN than not. Another consideration is that Internet Explorer is still installed and can be opened. So in the Internet options, we want to increase the security settings to high and the privacy settings to block all cookies. That way, if Internet Explorer were exploited, there is less chance of a successful attack. Avoid using legacy web technologies like Java, Flash, ActiveX, and Silverlight. Many high-traffic websites used elements made with Java or Flash, making it a huge target in terms of cybersecurity. Many Facebook games, for example, ran on Flash. These technologies have been moved away from, and there is little to no need for Java or Flash, so you won't be missing out on much not using these technologies on your Windows 7 PC. The safest path is to disable Flash if the browser you are using still supports it. There are a couple of settings we want to change to protect other PCs on the same network as our Windows 7 system. First, we want to turn off network discovery. This will prevent unwanted communication with other computers on the network. Then, we want to disconnect from the network. If you are using your Windows 7 system to perform tasks that do not require a connection to the internet, it is best to disconnect from the network. If there was some potential security issue on the same network as your system, or your system is compromised, it may pose a threat to other computers on the network. If you disconnect from the network, it minimizes that risk. Another setting we can change for the network adapter is using a security-focused DNS service. In the properties for IPv4, select Use the following DNS server address. Then enter the IP address for Cloudflare, which is 1.1.1.1, or the IP address of your preferred DNS provider. To further improve security, the next area we want to explore is with user accounts. Most critical vulnerabilities can be exploited successfully only if the user is logged into an account with administrative privileges. So what we want to do is create a new user account, a power user, so we can still install software, but not an administrator that has access to the system internals that can be exploited. We are all set with our new user account. Along with user accounts, there is the user account control. This setting can get a little annoying, but it does have adjustments. I highly recommend leaving the setting enabled. For the Ultimate and Enterprise editions of Windows 7, there is an included feature called BitLocker that allows you to encrypt the hard drive. There are several benefits to this. As we are aiming for security, I recommend encrypting the hard drive with BitLocker. Now to turn on Data Execution Prevention Protection. Data Execution Prevention Protection, or DEP, is designed to prevent the execution of malicious code on parts of the computer's memory that are intended to hold data rather than program code. Malicious code may be placed in these parts of memory during a buffer overflow attack, and an attempt may subsequently be made to execute it from this location. To get the maximum protection from DEP, ensure that it is turned on for all applications. If a particular application becomes unstable with DEP turned on, you can selectively disable it for that application. Then we can turn off Auto Run. When Auto Run is enabled and removable media such as a USB flash drive is attached to the system, it may attempt to do some function specified by the setting. This can cause malicious code to execute on the system without user intervention. Turning this feature off reduces the risk when using any kind of removable media. There is a tool to consider using, It's called the Enhanced Mitigation Experience Toolkit from Microsoft. It's a utility that helps prevent vulnerabilities in software from being successfully exploited. The simple explanation given by Microsoft is that it works using mitigation technologies. As we are trying to be as secure as possible, putting another layer between an attack and the software that's being exploited seems like a good idea to me. Then we want to consider the productivity software we're using. Like operating systems, productivity suites are not supported indefinitely by their developers. While Office 2010 will still run on Windows 7, it may not be the best choice, as it has not received any kind of security patches in many years. There are better alternatives to this and open source options that pose less of a security risk. Keep a restore point. In the event the computer does get some kind of virus, malware, etc., system restore may save you from having to do a full format and recovery. It's a three-step process. After the virus infects the system or the malicious code executes on your computer, step one is to disconnect from the network. Step two is to disable the antivirus software. And step three is to attempt a system restore. Note that the antivirus software needs to be disabled first, as it may cause system restore to fail. The next thing to consider is saving some tasks for systems that are currently supported by their developers. Online banking, for example, may not be the best application for a Windows 7 system. If possible, save those tasks for an Android smartphone or a Windows 11 system, or anything that's currently supported by its developer to continuously improve security. These are the strategies for how we can safely use Windows 7 forever. Thanks for stopping by. See you next video.